In the last video, I showed you guys how I go about using the custom shape tool to edit my image into a circle. And in this video, I'm going to show you guys how I put a mug template together and get it ready to be printed. I'm going to be printing a mug for my mother-in-law using some photos here of my son, and just going to show you how I go about doing that. The first thing we need to do is actually merge these layers here, because we won't be able to drag this photo and put it on the template if the layers are not merged. Let me show you what happens when you try and do that. So with the move tool up here selected, you want to try and drag the picture. I'm going to just show you kind of what happens. And see, it just takes the picture and it doesn't take the shape and all that, because this is still in layers. So in order to fix that, what we need to do is merge these layers. And so you go over here and basically you right click, and where it says merge visible layers, you can kind of even use merge down, but I just usually pick merge visible layers because sometimes I don't want some layers merged, only certain ones. So I got in the habit of just selecting merge visible. And there you go, you have it all on one layer. And so as you can see now, I can move it over. Now that I have this photo merged, I can bring in another picture that I want to use for the mug template. And I'm going to go ahead and also cut it into a circle shape. I'm going to come over to the custom shape tool and make sure that circle is selected, just like I did in the other video. And I'm going to hold down the shift key and I'm going to select my son's face, and we're going to go ahead and drag the photo once again over the shape and go to clipping masks, and then I'm going to reposition the picture by using the move tool and just going to go ahead and do that. Use the move tool now to reposition my picture, and once it's where I'd like it to be, I push enter. So now I want to add this outline, this blue outline, just like I did to my first picture. And I want to make sure that I'm on the shape layer, and I want to make sure that my custom shape tool is selected, and that'll bring up the toolbar, this toolbar here for the shape tool. I want to click stroke, and then the first color here, blue, is the same one I used last time. So it's already been saved there for me, and I'm just going to click it. So this outline is a little bit too wide. What I want to do now is come here to the slider and get it down to 10. What I also actually like to do better is just type in 10. For me, it's quicker. That's usually a size that I like. It's just subtle enough for my taste. So now it's perfect. And it's the same size as my previous picture. And now what I want to do is merge those two layers, because again, we want to be able to move this picture up to the template. So I need to click off the eyeball from the first layer, which is my first image. Click the eyeball, and that hides it. And then I want to go back up here, and I want to right click and merge visible again, and that's only going to merge the two layers that have the eyeballs. So then after I do that, I'm going to then make my other picture visible, and now I can move both of them. I also have here a background that I'm going to be using, and a couple of elements. So I just kind of want to show you guys how I do this. I'm going to get the move tool, and I'm going to drag over all the elements over to my template, and then I'm going to drag over the other picture. I'm going to go ahead and these little elements here, I want to kind of put them in here too, so I'm going to go ahead and drag those over. Okay, so now I've dragged them all into my mug template, and I kind of want to organize them now so it's a little bit easier to work with. I'm going to leave a safe space down here, and I'm going to turn that off for right now. And then we have the background layer here. And I'm going to be adjusting the background layer to fill in the bleed area. And then I always like to lock my background layer just so it's not moving around while I'm trying to move the images around or the other elements. And the way you do that is you come over here to that layer that's selected, and you click the little lock here, and that will lock this layer so that it's no longer movable. Like, you can't, it's just easier to design that way and move things around when the background is not movable. So now what I'm gonna do is just move the pictures around and kind of get them where I want them. And if I need to resize the picture, once again, you're gonna push the shift key, hold it down, and make it smaller, because that's gonna be way too big for the mug. And then enter to accept the transformation, go over to the other picture, hold the shift, and resize it. Enter. Once again, if I want to move this picture, I have to make sure it's selected in the layers palette. So now I'm going to go ahead and arrange the pictures. And so if I want to move this one, see, it's selected in the layers palette, and I can move it, make it bigger, smaller, move it around. And then if I want to move this picture, I have to come and click on it, and it'll highlight the layer. And I can also turn it like this a little bit. And my computer's running a little bit low because the RAM is a little low for this program. So, but that's about it. You can just move everything around and get it kind of where you want it. And once you have it, you want to try to stay within in the center here, because you're going to see now when we add our safe space here, you want to make sure you're in that area so that when you go to print, your pictures are not cut off. So I am going to move that over a little bit more because I think I'm still not in the right spot. And I'm gonna hold down the shift to make this picture a little bit smaller. And see how this, that word pow is in the back? I need to bring that above the picture. And so when I click on it, you're gonna see that in the layers palette, it's selected. And what you wanna do is right click and drag that all the way to the top. So now it's on top of the picture, and you could see it better. So I'm just going to leave this for right now, because I mean, it's, maybe it could be designed better, but just want to show you guys how I get this done and move on here. So I have the safe space that I had unclicked the little eyeball here so that I could work with the pictures and everything. And what you want to do now is turn it on by clicking a little eyeball. And as you can see, you really can't see it, and that's because it's in the background. So you want to go ahead and make sure it's above all the layers, and then that way it's exactly above it, so you can see through it and you can make sure you're going to be within the print area. So now that we have the safe space area visible, we can see that this picture is kind of on the border there, and it's kind of in danger of being cut off. So what you want to do is go over here to the safe space, and I just click it off. Click on the picture I want to move, making sure that the move tool is selected. I want to nudge it up a little bit. So the best way to move things slightly, and you can always use a move tool, but another quick tip or shortcut is to hold down the shift key again and use your up arrow, and that will move it any which way you want. And so to the right, to the left, and that helps do it quickly. And so now I'm going to highlight it again and make sure that all the pictures are within the safe area. So the next step is a little confusing, so I'm gonna go slow so I can show you exactly what to do, and hopefully it's not too confusing. You wanna first go ahead and go to this locked layer, and you wanna click to unlock it. You want to click the lock to unlock it, because we need it to be unlocked for this next step. So you're going to make sure that your safe space, the eyeball is removed, and the bleed area is also removed. So now you only have your elements and your photos and all that's visible, and you're going to right click. And again, we're going to use this merge visible. So now we have it all on one layer, and it's above the bleed area. I turned on the eye here so that it's visible. If you click it, you'll see the bounding box there of the bleed area. But we want to be on the image now that we want to print. And we're going to go ahead and clip it to the bleed area. And you're going to do that by clicking on it, right clicking, and selecting clipping mask. So now this has been clipped onto the bleed area. And one last time before I send it to print, I want to check the safe area. And yep, everything fits within the safe area that I want to print. And we can go ahead and remove it, because we don't want it to be visible when we send this file to print. So hopefully that's been helpful.